I grew up in the Midwest, and one's classmates in the Midwest, as nice as it is, often it's a restricted set of backgrounds and more homogeneous than when you go to college, and especially a place like MIT, which you all students from all over the country and from the world. So you meet a lot of people, and you learn there are lots of smart people in the world. So the competition becomes harder, and I think that's good. Suddenly, you know, you're free of parental guidance and influence. You have a tremendous amount of freedom. And I was fortunate in that I was a quick learner, so I got too cocky. I felt I didn't have to go to classes. Fortunately, I found Professor Lin, who was my advisor, and he helped me through that. So I learned two things. One was that you can recover from such mistakes. And the second, and this may not be something that most professors or university presidents would advise, but I felt actually not going to classes later proved to be beneficial. All right, now I don't think it works for everybody, but it worked for me because it taught me how to learn without being taught. And number two, I felt I was free of some of the conventional ways of thinking. In college, there were mentors. The strongest one was the person who turned out to be my thesis advisor. And later on, he also supervised my PhD thesis. And the thing I learned from him was that going to school, especially if you wanted to be a scientist, was much more than learning how to do things in a textbook manner. Textbook stuff was necessary, but it wasn't sufficient. There was a way of thinking about research to find out how to find out things that had never been known before, that nobody else knew. How to do that in a systematic, careful way that had a chance of being right. I think that's what human society is really about. We differ from animals in the way that we transmit knowledge, values, a sense of the past as a path toward the future. I think it's very important for people to be taught that, to be transmitted, so that there's a continuity in the way we do things. At the end of the Opium War, China was levied with a huge reparations for daring to resist the Allied powers. And seven Western powers extracted huge reparations from China. The United States, to its everlasting credit, gave back its portion of the reparations under the stipulation that the funds be used for educational purposes. So in 1911, at the founding of the Republic of China, that money was used to found Tsinghua University, which is where my advisor was a student, where my father was a student, and they had a mission, which was to send students abroad to learn the science and technology Western science and technology mostly, so that China would never suffer this humiliation again. And that's what they did. And those graduates, you know, who I saw every day because they were all my father's friends, had a sense of purpose to their life and a sense of mission that I'm not seeing in other places.